Good morning, dear students. Welcome once again. This time we are going to proceed with class 8 civics, chapter number 5, judiciary. The word judiciary, as you might have remembered, the system of courts, all the courts taken together, is known as judiciary. If you take, for example, Supreme Court, High Court, District Court, then village panchayat and all these things, the combination of all the courts is taken as judiciary. Let's try to find out the roles, the functions of judiciary. Okay? So, let's come up with some of the difficult terms. First term is eviction, which means removal of a person from land or homes. If you remove a person from land or home, that is called eviction, right? I have evicted a person, that means I have removed a person from the home, from the house, or from the land, right? Eviction, very simple term. Another term is violation. What is the meaning of violation? Violation means the act of breaking law. Breaking the law is known as violation, simple. Or infringement of fundamental rights. Infringement is synonym of violation. Violation of fundamental rights, because violation term is already given, that's why we use another term of violation, that is infringement. So either infringement of fundamental rights or breaking of law is known as violation. Another term is your acquit. Acquit means court declaring a person is not guilty. That means person is innocent. Guilty means one who does the crime or guilt. Guilty person. Not guilty person has not done anything. So he is acquitted. Okay, by jat bari karna, right? So court declaring person is not guilty of crime is acquit. Okay? To appeal. What is the meaning of to appeal? Appeal means to file a case. Okay? Petition filed before a higher court to hear the case which has already been decided by lower court. Suppose if you have a case, you first went to district court, lower court. There it has been decided. Okay? The final consequence or the result came of it. But if you are not happy with that, you can go to higher court. That's why the petition filed before a higher court. Case filed before a higher court to hear the case which has already been decided by lower court. Those cases which are being filed, which are being petitioned before the higher court, because the person is not happy with the lower court decision, that means to appeal. Okay? Now another term, the last but not the least of this chapter, compensation. Compensation, to compensate, to make amends. Amends means to make adjustment for an injury or a loss. Money given to make amends. Either you give the money for the injury or loss that has been given to somebody. Right? Suppose if you have done an accident with some other vehicle, you have given some money because there is a damage of that vehicle because of you. So you have compensated. Right? To give the money to make the amend for injury or loss. Right? Bharpai karna, to make an amend. Okay? So that means compensation. Okay? Money given for an injury or loss. Money given to make amend for injury or loss. Anything you can do. Okay, so these are the terms. Now let's start the chapter. Judiciary, the system of courts, is known known as judiciary. What are the roles of judiciary? These three are the roles of judiciary. Mind you, judiciary has three roles. If the question will be asked, what are the three roles of judiciary? What are the three duties of judiciary? You can write, first role, dispute resolution. Dispute means quarrel. Resolution to solve. Quarrel solving, dispute resolution. It resolves the dispute. Between whom? Between citizen. If there is a fight between citizen and citizen, it resolves the dispute. Between citizen and government, if there is a fight between a citizen and the government, then also it resolves the dispute. To state government, if state government and state government clashes together, suppose if Chhattisgarh government has a fight with MP government, again it clashes, it also resolves by judiciary. Between center and state, if there is a fight between the national government and the state government, then also it resolves. So it solves the dispute, it resolves the dispute between citizen and citizen, between citizen and government, between two state government, and between center and state. Okay, clear?
Yes.
Now another role of judiciary is judicial review. What is the meaning of judicial review? It means it has the power, judiciary has the power to strike down, to cross the particular law. It can cross, it can strike down the law if it believes that law violates the constitution. If judiciary know that the law violates the constitution, law is against the constitution, law creates problem to the constitution, it can strike down the particular law. So judiciary has the power to strike down the law, to cancel the law if law violates the constitution. Clear? Third function, role, third role, third function, enforcing fundamental rights. It gives fundamental rights. Every citizen approach the Supreme Court. Every person can go to Supreme Court if their rights were violated. If your rights are not being given to you, you can go to the Supreme Court and you can fight for your right. Six fundamental right. Right to equality. Right? Right to freedom. Right against exploitation. Right? Right against exploitation. After that, cultural and educational rights. Then you have rights to constitutional remedy. Right? So enforcing fundamental right means it has the role. If a citizen, all the citizen can go to the Supreme Court, they can approach the Supreme Court if their rights were violated, if their rights were seized, if their rights were taken. Okay? These are the roles of judiciary. Now, coming on to the independent judiciary. What do you mean by the term independent judiciary? See, in the first chapter only I have told you there are three organs, there are three departments. There is separation of power. Legislature is there, executive is there, and judiciary is there. These are the three organs into which power is divided. So, the independent judiciary means legislature and executive do not have the right of interfering the work of judiciary. If judiciary has given some decision, neither the legislature have the right nor the executive have the right to go against it. Okay, they can't interfere, they can't pose an obstacle in the work of judiciary. This is the meaning of independent judiciary. That means judiciary is responsible for their decision and legislature and executive has no right of interfering in the work of judiciary.
Clear?
Yes. Now coming on to the structure of court. This is the structure of court. At the lowest part, there is district court. Higher to district court is high court. And higher to high court is Supreme Court. Supreme Court is at the apex, at the top. A-P-E-X. Apex means top. So Supreme Court is the top. Supreme Court's order will be taken by the High Court as well as District Court. High Court and District Court can't neglect the Supreme Court's order. Moreover, High Court has higher power than District Court. So High Court's decisions were taken by District Court but not by the Supreme Court, because for because the power of Supreme Court is highest. So all the decisions of Supreme Court is final. Okay? So this is the structure. That means Supreme Court is having the highest power, then High Court, then District Court at the lowest. So District Court decisions were being solved out by the High Court. High Court can give the decisions after the District Court, and High Court decisions can also be undertaken by Supreme Court. But Supreme Court's order is for both, and High Court orders should be followed by the District Court. This is the structure of courts. Now PIL, understand this term PIL, very important term, public interest litigation. The full form of PIL is public interest litigation. Okay, it is introduced by Supreme Court in the year 1980s. So in the year 1980s, Supreme Court has introduced this PIL, public interest litigation. What does it actually mean, public interest litigation? It allowed the individual or organization to file PIL in High Court or Supreme Court on behalf of those rights were violated. That means any person can file a case on behalf of the person, other person, if his rights were violated, if another person's are having some harm or injury. Okay, as for example, suppose if there is a road which is in bad condition, because of which every day many accidents are occurring. So you can, being a responsible citizen, can file a PIL, public interest litigation, on behalf of all the citizens, that this road should be maintained by the government, because every day too many accidents are coming on, or every day too many accidents are occurring on this road. Clear? So public interest litigation means individual or organization file PIL in High Court or Supreme Court on behalf of other citizen, on behalf of those whose rights were violated. That means if another person's rights were violated or are being not followed, that means other person's rights were being not given or seized, okay, then another person can file on behalf of him. Okay, that is the meaning of PIL. Importance of judiciary. Now what is the importance of judiciary? There are two importance of judiciary. It keeps control on powers of executive and legislature. Number one, it can control the power of executive and legislature so that there will be no tyranny. Yes, there will be no unjust or criminal use of the power, right? So importance of judiciary, it keeps control on the powers of executive and legislature. And another thing is, it helps in protecting fundamental rights of citizen. It protects the fundamental right of the citizen. Two roles of judiciary, two importance of judiciary: keeps control on powers of executive and legislature, and it helps in protecting the fundamental rights of citizen, right? So these are the cases. Coming on to the question answer of the textbook, your first question, you read that one of the main functions of judiciary is upholding the law and enforcing fundamental rights. That means law and enforcing fundamental rights are the main functions of judiciary, which we have right now learned. Why do you think an independent judiciary is necessary to carry out important functions? Why you think that independent judiciary is necessary? An independent judiciary is necessary because, first, it ensures there is no misuse of power by legislature and executive. Yes, right now we have learned it keeps control over the executive and legislature. So if there should be no misuse of power, if we want that there is no misuse of power by legislature and executive, then there should be an independent judiciary. Judiciary must function on its own, right? And second is, anyone can approach court if they believe that their rights have been violated. So if anybody thinks that their rights were violated, their rights were not being given, they are not able to use up their rights well, they can approach the court. Okay, that's why judiciary should be independent, so that it can give proper rights to the people, to the citizen, moreover, to prevent the misuse of power or tyrannical power of legislature and executive is very important. Understood? Yes. Coming on to the next question. Reread the list of fundamental rights provided in the chapter 1. How do you think the right to constitutional remedy connect to the idea of judicial review? See, you have to only define judicial review and constitutional remedy, sixth fundamental right, right? Only you can define, they will be correlated. The right to constitutional remedy allows an Indian citizen to move to the court if he feels that his or her fundamental right have been violated. Your sixth fundamental right, right to constitutional remedy, clearly tells that citizen can go to the court, can go to the Supreme Court if they feel that their rights have been violated. And judicial review, judiciary has the power to review or strike down the particular law passed by the parliament if it believes that law violates the basic structure of constitution. In this way, both are connected and supported by judicial review. You have to write the judicial review, which I have already told, right? Judicial review, one of the role of judiciary, right? To strike down any particular law if it believes that the law violates the constitution, right? So these are to be taken care of, right? Yes. So judiciary has the power to review or strike down any particular law passed by parliament if it believes that this law violates the basic structure of constitution. And the right to constitutional remedy also allows the citizen to go to the court if their fundamental rights have been violated. So in this way they are connected and supported, right? Now question number 3. There is a Sudha Goyal case. What happens in Sudha Goyal case? Sudha has been burnt down because of dowry and other things, okay? She has been burned by the husband and mother-in-law, okay? So mother-in-law, husband, and there is brother-in-law, okay? They were put to jail. Then what happens in lower court? Lakshman, which is his brother-in-law, his mother Sakuntala, and his brother-in-law Subhash, सॉरी लक्ष्मण वाज द नेम ऑफ हस्बैंड, ब्रदर इन लॉ वाज सुभाष एंड मदर वाज शकुंतला, मदर इन लॉ. ओके, ऑल वेयर सेंटेंस्ड टू डेथ. ओके, ऑल वेयर सेंटेंस्ड टू डेथ फाइंडिंग दैट दे हैव बर्नड हर. बट बिकॉज दे वर नॉट हैप्पी विद द डिसीजन ऑफ लोअर कोर्ट, दीज थ्री मूव डाउन टू हाई कोर्ट एंड देयर दे हैव अपील्ड, राइट? देन देयर दे इट हैज बीन प्रूव्ड दैट लक्ष्मण, शकुंतला एंड सुभाष वेर नॉट गिल्टी पर्सन, सो दे वेर एक्विटेड. नाउ बिकॉज दे वेर एक्विटेड देन द इट देन द ऑपोजिशन ऑफ इट, दैट मीन्स the parents of Sudha, they have filed the case in Supreme Court and finally Lakshman, Shakuntala were given life imprisonment because they were the culprits, while Subhas was acquitted because there was no evidence that he was present at that time. Okay, so this was the final decision which are to be followed by High Court as well as Lower Court. Clear? Yes. So this was the thing only in Sudha Goyal case. Keeping the Sudha Goyal case in mind, pick the sentence that are true and correct the one that are false. You have to pick the sentence that are true and you have to correct also that one are false. First question, the accused, the guilds took the case to the High Court because they were unhappy with the decision of trial court. That's true. Yes, they were not happy with the case, with the decision of trial court, lower court, right? That's why they moved to High Court. Another question, they went to High Court after the Supreme Court had given its decision. False. They went to Supreme Court after High Court's decision, right? Yes, you can move upwards, not downwards, right? So they went to High Court after the decision of trial court, you can also say. After the decision of the trial court, they moved on to High Court, right? Yes. Third one. If they do not like the Supreme Court verdict, suppose if they do not like the Supreme Court decision, the accused can go back again to the trial court. No, false. If any decisions are being given in the Supreme Court, at the highest court, then you don't have any other way. You have to follow it. So accused cannot go back to trial court since Supreme Court is at highest apex of judiciary. Okay, so you cannot move on to trial court since Supreme Court is at the highest apex of judiciary. Clear? Question number 5. Why do you think the introduction of public interest litigation, PIL, in the 1980s is a significant step in ensuring access to justice for all? Yes, it is significant step in ensuring access to justice for all. Why? Because it keeps in mind the interest of illiterate, moreover poor, or those who cannot afford to access the Indian legal system. Those people who are poor and illiterate, who don't know even ABC of the courts, they can also go to the court, they can also appeal in the court by the help of this public interest litigation. Okay, that's why it is an important step in ensuring access to justice for all. Okay, for the interest of illiterate, for the interest of poor who cannot afford to access the Indian legal system, Indian courts. There is another case of Olga Tellis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation. Okay, the judgment on the Olga Tellis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation case. Write in your own words what the judges meant when they said that the right to livelihood was part of the right to life. Here in the judgment, the court has given a sentence that right to livelihood was part of right to life. Okay, you have to prove that. Right to livelihood means earning daily livelihood, earning money is a part of right to life. Yes, obviously. So in Olga Tennis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation case, the judges said that right to livelihood was part of right to life. Here comes the answer. They stated that life does not merely imply an animal existence. Life does not means animal existence. What do animals do? They hunt for the animals. They kill other animal and eat. They don't have to earn, but humans are born to earn. So, the life does not merely imply animal existence. It can't be lived without means of living. If you don't have the source of income, you can't live in society. Means of livelihood, that means, okay? That means means of living means means of livelihood. The judges conferred, judges meant that eviction from pavement or slum is deprivation of means of livelihood. See, people are living on the street. They were buying and selling the products, and by me that means they were earning their livelihood. Now when they were removed from the street, they lost their livelihood. They have not lost their shelter, they lost their livelihood also. That's why judges conferred told that removing these people from pavement, from street or slum is a deprivation, is removal of livelihood of those people. For the poor who cannot afford to live anywhere, they now don't have the affordability, they can't have the power of living anywhere. So they were certainly have deprivation of life. That means if you can remove a poor from the livelihood, from the earning, you are removing a poor from its life. That is true. Understood? Yes, that is the meaning. If you are removing a poor from the livelihood, from the daily earning, you can removing a person from life. Okay, simple. Homework, what is the role of judiciary? You have to answer. Moreover, what do you mean by term judiciary? You have to answer these two questions as a homework. Note it down. Till then, bye. Next time I am going to come up with another new chapter.